They say that the best things in life are free, and I'm pretty sure that they are people who have plenty of money in their bank balances, in their bank accounts. The best things in life are definitely not free. We have Sonam Kapoor right in front of us, who's wearing something, I'm sure, which is very, very, very expensive. Sonam, the first thing I want to ask you,
it's all been lent.
It's all been lent, but it is expensive. That's why you look fabulous.
Well, not exactly. Nothing that I'm wearing. This is all like Indian designers, and they're not very expensive at all, actually.
Okay, that's very, very good news, because honestly, you know, I think for a lot of us, we feel that, you know, you have to spend money really to look good.
No.
So Ayushman, I'm going to start with Sonam on this.
Go for
okay
it.
Because
no.
I want to know, you know, is it possible really to be a recessionista?
Absolutely. I love that. I think so. I'm telling you, if you give me 200 rupees or 300 rupees and put me out there, I will find you an outfit which will make you look amazing. It's also how you wear it. Mm. A lot of the times, because people already expect me to wear designer clothes, even when I'm not wearing designer clothes, they think, oh my God, ye toh bahut hi expensive designer hoga, ye ladki kya pehen rahi hai types. But it's not. And a lot of the times I'm in high street stuff, or I'm in vintage clothes, which are like really cheap. I'm not saying that I come from a impoverished background at all, but we had budgets, but we had to look good and look nice. So not out of choice, but out of desperation, we started going to thrift stores and vintage stores and secondhand stores and stuff like that. And we created a kind of identity, and we started loving clothes a lot because of that. Because, you know, you have to make something out of, I think, creativity. And the best things are also always born out of the fact that you have less money.
You're so passionate about it, but really the one who should be doing it in the film, I think, is Ayushman.
But she has no choice, right, Maya? Because she's like giving him all the money, so she has to sacrifice according to her.
He's making a girl sacrifice.
In real life, I think my sense of style is evolving because of Sonam Kapoor.
I swear, you know, my sense of style is evolving just by listening to it. I feel myself.
You know, when we go for promotions,
I
spend that extra hour to think, what am I wearing, because I need to compliment what she's wearing during promotion.
So you put a lot of pressure, I have to say, on your leading man.
There's no pressure. There's no pressure.
I meant that in a good way, because even I think Farhan has recently said that. He was like, because, you know, like, you up the game. You kind of make everyone up the game, because you're always so incredibly turned out.
That's amazing. That's amazing.
Yeah.
In fact, sometimes I click my pictures and, you know, send her the options. What should I wear?
Yeah. Should I wear the vintage?
And sometimes sometimes the answer is none.
Oh.
Like, you know, for example, Dhanush was like, I give up. You dress me.
Poor Dhanush. You're a little bit better off than Dhanush, I think. Fashion wise.
No, I was like, Dhanush was like, what? Yeah. I was like, don't worry.
Yeah.
I was like, call this designer, call the designer, do this, do that. And eventually he was like, fully like dressed and then
set. Yeah,
he
actually started becoming very sharply dressed and all of that now.
During Ranjana, when we were promoting, he wanted to wear certain clothes. Like, he was like, they're not used to it, down south promotions and stuff like that.
Yeah,
so he had no idea there were so many changes.
Yeah.
He was completely lost and he's like, I can't take it.
Yeah.
So I was like, just do not worry, do not think about it. I just got him all the clothes, you know, and we got it done. And Farhan and me just had a little bit of a understanding.
Which was all your side of the understanding. Yeah, I will lead and you will follow.
No,
that
it wasn't that. He was just like, the only thing is, we went to, he was like, he's coolly dressed and whatever. I was like, Farhan, I'm going to wear this. Please don't wear a t-shirt and come.
Because you want to look like you're on the
same page. And if you're going to wear a t-shirt, please tell me you're going to wear a t-shirt and a beanie.
Yeah. Beanie.
You know, where's his head? He's on his head.
I've been there and done that.
Because he has that hair, right?
Sorry. Like,
radio
that
joke.
What is going on? Ayushman, this is what happens when people sit with you.
No, my sense of humor is terrible on its own.
No, this is the third time it's happened today. I've done interviews with all of you guys.
Yeah.
But as soon as you sit with Ayushman, these things
it's
come
like
out.
It's like how you force people to be fashionable, Ayushman forces people to be funny. So you have to be fashionable and funny when you're around the two of you.
Oh my God, it's exhausting.
You know, both of you all make a very interesting pair on screen. And I'm sure both of you must have come to like the first day on set with certain preconceived notions, like how we think of Sonam as fashionable, we think of you as funny. But you know, what was the thing?
It was
actually
complete opposite.
Oh, was it?
I don't know why people think it was funny. I don't know. I'm
you know,
I'm
in
just
fact,
not a
I
guy.
Have to say, I actually told someone that today. Yeah. Not to take anything away from you, but I think a lot of people tend to think, oh, Ayushman is like this really like laugh a minute kind of guy. And I said, I don't think he is.
No, not at all.
I think he's actually kind of a serious guy. Yeah. In some ways. Am I right about that?
No, but it's everybody's impression of him. So that was my impression. I was like, this is going to be one loud Punjabi guy. Everybody's going to be loud in Punjabi on the set, including me and Rishi Kapoor. So all of us are going to be really loud in Punjabi on this film.
And then there's this quiet,
but this is quiet, brooding, introspective, with his guitar, writing poetry.
Okay, even I had my preconceived notion about Sonam Kapoor that, you know, I thought that, you know, she's a style icon.
Hmm.
And I'm this guy next door.
Hmm.
And I was very skeptical about the chemistry.
Yeah.
But when we went on the set, we did readings, narration, we started filming. Then I discovered that she's a simple girl, very approachable, and that was a great revelation.
And you know, obviously coming back to the whole idea of this film, you know, recession and things like that, you know, romance is one thing which really suffers in a recession, and I think more and more young people are really seeing that actually today for real.
Yeah.
You know, because their boyfriend's out of a job, girlfriend's out of a job.
So sad.
It is really sad because it actually puts a lot of pressure. It doesn't, I think, allow young people to just really enjoy.
Actors, sometimes live in a bubble.
Yeah.
In this day and age, they're doing very well.
Yeah.
This is the best time to be an actor.
Absolutely.
All the new actors are coming. Yeah. Everybody's doing good films.
So much
everybody's earning well, good opportunities, but they don't see the outside world that, you know, people are suffering from recession.
Yeah,
I'm talking about the actors, not the producers.
I'm so sorry to kind of say that, but because I come from a production family and I know what's going on because we're trying to make films and we're trying to make interesting films and different films. A lot of the distributors are suffering. A lot of the cinema owners are suffering.
Talking about the actors.
He's talking about the actors.
I know, even actors, you know. Ayushman, even like 2-3 years ago, the kind of monies that were given to the big stars, people are skeptical about giving that kind of money.
Because
now
they're new stars.
Mm.
New stars on board, and they're earning money from events. You know, there are a lot of events happening.
Not as much as they used to.
Okay, so
because I do a lot of events. I've been doing events for the past 6 years now. So I know that.
Okay.
Yeah.
So clearly there's a slight difference of opinion. But
no, it's not difference of opinion at all. But the thing is, because he's doing well.
Yeah.
Like he is one of those
really
people.
He's the exception rather than the rule.
No, I think the young actors are doing. I'm not sure about. I don't know about the other actors. I know the young breed. They're doing pretty well, and it's all relative, I think. They have not seen the earlier picture. Yes. And it's all relative, bigger stars and the young stars.
Yeah.
And but having said that, they are slightly oblivious of the fact that
absolutely.
The world
outside that I agree with.
Is completely different.
Of
that's
course.
What I keep on saying.
You know, you can't compare your world, really. I mean, I hate to say it like that, but you can't compare your
world.
No, I agree.
Like, because we live in a snow globe, especially when you're in Bollywood, you live in a snow globe.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like this thing where you can't, like you don't know what's going on in the outside world at all. That's what I discovered before I signed these couple of films like Ranjana, Baby Kufia and Milkha.
It's interesting and I'm surprised actually, you know, it hasn't really come up before because I think we've all been experiencing this now for, you know, the last, I think about at least 3 to 4 years, this has been going on.
Yeah, I think so. I think it started a couple of years back. I think it's still going on. I mean, the rupee hasn't been lower than what it's been. And instead of, there's so many people just like throwing like accusations at each other, mudslinging, instead of actually making promises to the public and telling us how they're going to change the way that they're going to, you know, what changes they're going to make.
Politics has always been like that.
Yeah.
But I still feel that, you know, this phase is slightly better because there are people who are slightly more approachable now.
Mm-hmm.
We can talk to the public directly.
Mm-hmm.
We have social media as well. So I think it's slightly better than before.
You know, if you had a partner, you know, who was perhaps going through this, I know you feel that you're kind of disconnected from this world and things like that. If you had a partner who was going through something like this, had lost a job, what would you do?
You know, my friends are going through this for sure. Because I have very, very few friends in the film industry. A lot of my friends are from school.
Yeah.
And they're from and not only friends in Bombay, like friends everywhere else. You know, one of my friends is an interpreter, and one of my friends does PR for hotels. One of my friends does. Is an anchor, you know, from school, all these people, and they're all going through it, you know, and all of them are saying, you know, we are not getting a raise, you know, expenses are rising, I need a new job, because I'm out of a job. It's awful and it's scary, and you know, the kind we had so much, like when we hit 21, 22, all of us were starting out at that point.
Such big dreams.
We had such big dreams.
Yeah.
And now everybody's become like jaded and cynical. And it's very different from what I'm going through right now. You're right. Because right now I feel like this is the brink of me starting out. And it's scary. It's so scary because, you know, you see your friends around you and you see your people, the people around you that aren't actually,
does it affect your friendships also?
Of course it does.
Like, I mean, a friendship, I'm sure it affects. Can you imagine? Or romance?
Relationships? Yeah. I don't know what happens. Because it's, you're in a relationship, it's a partnership, right?
Yeah.
But like, for example, I wanted to go. We promised each other that we'll do holidays once a year. Mm. Like, just all the girls. Mm. But this year, only half of us are coming because they're like, we can't afford it.
Yeah. Yeah. And then if you offer to pay for someone, then that gets into this
It gets into like a really... Yeah. murky space, you know. Yeah. So even this year, we didn't want to go out again and again and again for New Year's. But it's just economical.
I think on guys, when you're out of a job, I've seen this with male friends of mine, you know, people who I've known very, very closely.
Nobody's going to buy them a drink.
Yeah, it's just, you know, honestly, it just hits their confidence so hard. And I don't think they can really talk about it to anybody because it's just such an ego issue.
I agree.
I think,
as a guy, what do you feel? Yeah, like, I mean, how does one deal with it?
There's a constant debate in the film as well. Yeah. And, the professional life is directly proportional to the personal life for a guy.
Yeah,
if he's sad professionally, he cannot really go with the relationship in a happy manner. And apart from that, I think, having said that, if you have a partner who's earning better than you and you're slightly jobless, then I think you should
slightly jobless.
You're jobless.
He's still defending it.
Yeah. Because no guy will buy this. I'm jobless.
Yeah.
I'm slightly jobless, looking for a job.
I'm just between them.
Yes,
it's not a common situation.
Yes.
So how do you recession-proof your romance? What do you think?
Well, like what Ayushman says, which I think makes a lot of sense. You have to kill your ego. And you have to, this is what we were saying as well, that you need to truly become partners. Mm. It's not like your money and my money. It's our money. So it's like a pool. It's like a bank. You put it in there and you kind of balance it out. And you do not think of it as just my money and I'm giving it to him, or, you know, this is what I owe you because I've taken this money from you. It's just, it's wrong and negative.
And,
you know, when you're in a relationship.
And it's like keeping score, which is just the death knell of every relationship.
I think it's more to keep yourself happy during that time.
Yeah.
Just keep your confidence high. Yeah. Watch movies, read books. Just do things which make you evolve. Yeah.
Yeah. And you know, positive. And honestly, for the person who has a job and the person doesn't, love that person.
Yeah.
Be patient with that person.
Yeah. I think a lot of women, actually, I have to say, like, you know, we always complain about how guys go just for looks. I think a lot of women go just for bank balances.
I agree with you.
And I think that's so unfair because, you know, we judge them for looking just at the outside, but we're kind
of doing the same. But that's what I mean. That's so wrong. And that's what, you know, like, I was just, again, I'm going to bring my friends in because that's who I draw my experiences from, because obviously we don't live in the real world. So a couple of my friends, like, got married for the wrong reasons. Not because of anything, family pressure, etc.
I love the fact that you're saying this. I think it's something so many women out there really
and the thing is, like, two of them are very happily married right now, but one of them got married to this really well-to-do guy who comes from a good family, etc. 3 years into the relationship, they lost everything. Now the thing is, it was an arranged thing. It was like a meeting, and because he had, so but there was no love, right? It's an arranged thing. The thing is, now when there's no love,
what do you fall back on?
How do you build from that? So even 10 years down the line, or even 15 years down the line, if you get married to someone for the wrong reasons, and suppose everything goes away, then what do?
That's all you're left with,
with nothing, with no love and no money and no anything. But if you actually love that person and something like that happens, then you can still work with it. And if you love that person, if you marry that person for the right reasons and you build your life together, then maybe something can come off it as well.
Absolutely.
So you should always marry for the right reasons, because you never know what's going to happen, ever.
Sonam is a very, very wise woman. Honestly, I think a lot of women out there really need to hear that, because there's so many girls, I think especially at a time like this when financial
security is so important. Marry someone with potential. Marry someone with potential. Potential and ambition, and someone who you truly love. Yeah. I think that's what's important.
Yeah.
Someone who you know. I mean, the sexiest thing to me is ambition and a man who loves me a lot.
Yeah.
That, to me, is very, very sexy.
Yeah.
not someone who has
your
money.
Wife probably agrees with that,
you know,
right?
Of course, definitely.
Yeah. If you, he had like 10,000 yes, in his account. Yeah, I think
kudos to that. You know what I mean? It takes a lot of courage and a lot of guts to do something like
and
that.
And you need to be very true to your feelings.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And you need to be sure and confident. Like, this guy's a good guy. He loves me. And he has potential. And he's ambitious for what he wants. So even if whatever I said and done, I know he's going to do the best that he can do. And we can make our lives together.